let's take a look at some of this week's hobby happenings. All right, well, the Patriots may not have won another Super Bowl, but that didn't keep one collector from cashing in and capitalizing on the hype surrounding the GOAT. Last Thursday, a Tom Brady rookie card sold for $250,000, shattering the record for the highest price paid for a Brady collectible and the second highest price ever paid for a modern-day sports card. Brady's 2000 Playoff Contenders Championship rookie autograph ticket is limited to just 100 copies. The previous high for any Brady collectible sold at auction was a game-used jersey, which sold last February for $57,500. Quite a bargain in comparison.
Now, was that his actual Super Bowl jersey that went missing, or was that a different jersey?
No, that was a different one. The only modern-day card that has ever sold for more money than this Brady card was this one, the LeBron James Logoman 1-of-1 rookie card, which sold in 2016 for $312,000. The Brady card, just slurp during my segment.
I'm really sorry. It was unintentional. My coffee was so hot. I didn't realize.
The Brady card that was sold is in the best condition of all those that have been submitted for grading. The card was consigned to well-known Probstein 123, the largest volume sports memorabilia seller on eBay, with $29 million in sales on the site in 2017.
2017 alone?
Alone. Talk about a return on investment.
Speculation.
The owner of the card purchased it 3 years ago for $15,000, for those of you keeping track at home. That's a percentage increase of 1,566.67%. Absolutely unbelievable.
Did he purchase it raw or already in that grade?
Already in that grade.
Excellent. Well, I guess the newest thing on the market is Brady coin. Speaking of names in the hobby, Jefferson Burdick, Dr. James Beckett, Steve Grad, Rob Hemphill. At first glance, one of these things is not like the other. After all, the first three are true hobby pioneers and celebrities. Jefferson Burdick, whose lifelong labor of love gave us the American card catalog we use today. Dr. James Beckett, who gave us one of the first standardized price guides and created a hobby media powerhouse, including our fellow podcasters, the Fat Packs. And Steve Grad, thanks to his numerous appearances on the TV show Pawn Stars, has helped autograph authentication become a household term. So then, who exactly is Rob Hemphill? Well, he has arguably been one of the most influential people in the hobby you've never heard about until now. Hemphill has run a thriving sports memorabilia business in the San Francisco area for 29 years. After rediscovering the hobby in 1988... You thought your junk wax era departure was long. He noticed there was a strong emphasis on baseball cards and memorabilia, but that football seemed underserved in the market. So that's when he had one of his first hobby-changing ideas. Rob, not happy with the way autographs looked on traditional footballs, in partnership with memorabilia manufacturer Wilson, invented the now famous white panel football. I did not know.
How about that?
Yeah. However, his contributions to the hobby did not stop there. At the height of Hall of Famer Jerry Rice's career, Hemphill contacted him about doing an autograph signing. But he had the idea that instead of having to go to a public show, because a lot of people all over the country can't travel just to go see Jerry Rice and get his autograph, as much as we'd all love to, what if people could send in their items to him at the warehouse, he'll get them autographed by Jerry, or people can order the merchandise from him? Well, Hemphill called it a private signing, and the term stuck industry-wide and is a staple in the memorabilia business today. The success of the white panel football led to the invention and manufacturing by Spalding of both the white panel NBA basketball and the mini basketball, although the red, white, and blue basketball is still the greatest in terms of memorabilia. He's even come up with a way to properly reinflate autographed footballs without ruining the signatures. That's impressive, Rob. He said it took him over 200 attempts to get the technique right. Now Wilson steers its customer inquiries directly to Hemphill. So, Rob, that's hobby innovator Rob Hemphill.
That's pretty cool. Wow, who knew? Well, Ivan, we have another hobby find. Flashback, if you will, with me to the late 1960s when one Uncle Pete and his namesake nephew are on their regular route in Essex County, New Jersey.
Sorry, I thought it was fitting in that context.
After pulling up to a candy store, they find a half case of unopened 1966 Topps football cards.
And immediately opened it.
That memory stayed with the nephew, now age 68, forever. And last year, Uncle Peter unfortunately passed away, and the task of cleaning out his home fell upon his nephew. While they were close, he didn't know exactly what to expect. Sure enough, buried in the basement behind a wine press was the case.
Unopened.
Well, the good news is that there was a single complete unopened box of 24 sealed 5-cent wax packs, beautifully preserved for 5 decades. This rare find is up to $26,000 in early bidding in Golden's winter auction. Steve Hart, the owner of Baseball Card Exchange and the hobby's premier expert in unopened vintage wax, told Ken Golden, the auction house's founder, that the back box was in absolutely, quote, ridiculous condition. So with Hart's certification, Uncle Peter's find is the only certified original unopened box from 1966 Topps football found to date. However, what nephew Peter is trying to figure out is what happened to the packs from the other 11 boxes. Well, one theory being put forth by Golden is that Uncle Pete gave them out on Halloween. Which is okay, because I'm sure at the time he had no idea they'd be worth $1,500 a pack today.
Interesting. Well, Rob, our friends over at Sports Collectors Daily dug up this story. And if you're planning on visiting the East Coast anytime this summer, the National, you may want to add this destination to your travel plans. Reason being is that a major exhibition featuring baseball history and artifacts will open in June at the Library of Congress. The exhibit, titled Baseball Americana, will debut prior to Major League Baseball's All-Star Game, which Washington, D.C. will host. The exhibit will be in place for about a year. Featured artifacts will include the first handwritten and printed references to baseball in America, early rules of the game, historical baseball images, familiar players from some of the library's collection of early baseball cards, rare interviews and clips of Hall of Fame players, including Babe Ruth, Jackie Robinson, and others, vintage memorabilia, and much more. Coinciding with the exhibit will be the release of an updated copy of the classic book, Baseball Americana, Treasures from the Library of Congress, which includes hundreds of historical images and numerous milestones of the national pastime. The exhibition will be organized into 5 sections, but for that information and much more about this wonderful new exhibit, you'll have to read the article over on sportscollectorsdaily.com.
Very cool. Cleveland technically isn't the East Coast. It's like the Midwest. So,
look, I'm in California now. And not to mention that when you're in Omaha, Nebraska, Cleveland is the East Coast. So okay. You can make it happen. Get a puddle jump.
If you're going to the All-Star game, though, that'd be a really nice, like, 1-2 punch for your weekend, though. Okay, file this last story under great customer service. Today, Fanatics Authentic announced what they are calling their trade-resistant jersey program. I mean, let's face it, few things are more frustrating than buying a jersey of your favorite player and then shortly afterwards having them wind up being traded elsewhere.
Yes.
Well, with the Fanatics trade-resistant jersey program, worry no more. Why? Because Fanatics will give you a free replacement jersey if the active pro player you purchased switches teams within 90 days of your purchase, including free shipping. How cool is that? Some restrictions do apply, so visit fanatics.com/jersey-assurance for complete details. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.